Assalamu alaikum friends, I'm Dr. Mahdi Hashim from Advanced Software Channel. Welcome to our tutorials. Today we will learn how to pick image from camera or storage such as gallery. But before I start, I would like to remind you to practice and practice and practice, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel and activate the bell to receive our tutorials quickly. Okay, let's start. First of all, I will change this constraint layout. I don't like it actually. I'll replace it with relative layout, and we don't need the text view. So I'll insert image view. I'll give dimensions, for example 250 dB and 250 dB, and the source, for example, and center impedance true, and ID, for example, image. Okay, in the main activity I will define the image view, image view image, and in the onCreate image equals find view by ID r dot id dot image. Okay, now we'll create onClick listener for this image. So I'll write image dot set on a click listener, new on a click listener. Okay, and here we create a value such as boolean or string or end to check if the user will choose from camera or from gallery. For example, here I'll use boolean pick equals true, and if pick equals true, so for example I will select the image from camera, and else will be from the gallery. And here if the pick is true, so I'll check for camera permission. So I write if, and I will create a new method that returns true or false. If this new method returns false, and I name it check camera permission, it is a method. If this check camera permission returns false, so I'll create another method, request camera permission. Else I'll pick the image, for example I'll name the method as pick image, and if the user selects the image from storage, so we can copy this and paste, and we'll do the same way but this time with storage. And here storage. So now we have five methods. We'll create them one by one. For this one, check camera permission, create in the main activity. Okay, and this method will return true or false. So for camera we need two permissions, one for camera and one for storage. So I'll create new boolean variable, for example this one, this will equal context compat dot check self permission, and here we need the context and the manifest permission for camera. Okay, and this must equal to package manager dot permission granted. I'll take copy and paste for result 2, and here we need write external storage permission. Okay, and this method will return both res1 and res2. and rest 2. Okay, so finished the first method. By the same way, we'll create the check storage permission in the main activity also. And here in this permission, we need only write external storage, so we can copy this sentence and paste it here, and we return rest 2. That is, for the request camera permission, we create it again in the main activity, and here we'll check the permission code. So I write request permissions. The first thing is string permissions, so new string manifest dot permission dot camera, and manifest dot permission dot write external permission, and we add the request code, for example 100. This value actually as you want. Okay, and we have error here because of my version, Android version, so I'll add annotation to this to correct the error. And here we also we need to add annotation for the override method. Okay, and for request storage permission, by the same way, in the main activity, we'll copy this sentence again and paste it here. And for the camera, we don't need the camera permission, and we add annotation here. Okay, we have the last method is pick image. We'll create it, and this method is responsible to pick image from gallery. If you want to make this way more professional, I have this library from GitHub named Android Image Cropper, and this library allow us to make crop for any image. So what we need to do is copy the dependencies and paste it in the Gradle. And sync it. Okay, done. The next step is to copy and paste the permissions. For this, we need read external storage and write external storage. Copy. And in the manifest file, we'll add this permissions. And we'll add another one for the camera. Okay, what else? We need to add the activity to the manifest, for example here, and we need this sentence. We'll put it in the main activity in the big image. Okay, import class and import class. And we can replace this to crop image dot activity dot start, and we put the context only. That is, one more thing is to copy the on activity result, all of this, and we'll put it in the after onCreate method. At this point, if we test the app, it will allow us to pick image from camera or gallery. We test it. So if we press the image view, for example gallery, okay, the gallery opened already, and I'll choose this smiley girl, very cute. Crop, it's cropped already, but the image not shown in the image view. So what can we do is here in the activity result, we can apply two methods. The first one let's write try and catch exception E to avoid any crash, and we print the error. And here we'll decode this URI to bitmap, so we write import stream equals to get content resolver dot open import stream, and we'll enter the result URI, and we'll convert this stream to bitmap using bitmap factory. So we write bitmap equals bitmap factory dot decode stream, and simply we'll write a stream. Now we converted the URI to bitmap, so we just write the image view dot set image bitmap, and we'll enter the bitmap. We test again. Okay, when you click the image view from gallery, okay, and we choose this girl. Okay, it's shown already. And if we press again to check the camera opened already. We pick image, okay, and we can crop it and crop. Yes, good. The second way to show this URI in the image view is to use Picasso library from GitHub. It is very easy library. We just need to copy this dependencies and paste it in the Gradle file. And we just changed this version. It didn't work with me. And sync. Okay, done. And here in the main activity, we can delete all this and just write Picasso dot with context this dot load the URI result and dot into image view. If we test again, and click the image view, for example camera or gallery, and this sad boy group, it will be shown again in the image view. I hope you find this tutorial useful for you, but again I want to remind you to practice many times for this tutorial, and don't forget to subscribe in the channel and activate the bell to receive our tutorials, and thank you for watching.